بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful.
سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. سبحان الله والحمد لله ولا إله إلا الله.
رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن اهتدى بهداه وبعد. Honorable علماء, beloved brothers and listeners, we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once again for having granted us this opportunity to complete Salat al-Taraweeh. If we are to count the nights, wallahi, we have crossed so many nights into Ramadan, time is flying. Every moment of Ramadan is valuable. When Ramadan goes, we don't want to find ourselves regretting that Ramadan came and went and we did not achieve as much as we could. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the true achievement from the month of Ramadan. Tonight's recitation, we read the sixth para, and as I had mentioned last night, that tonight we were only going to read one para, and this is why you find we have finished 5 or 10 minutes before the normal time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this juz, in the sixth juz, has mentioned a lot about the people of the book, Yahud, Nasara, the Jews, the Christians. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has explained to us where they have deviated. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has explained to them where they have deviated. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has very pleasantly invited them to accept the truth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told them not to follow the bad ways and habits, etc., etc. So there is a lot of concentration on the people of the book. We call them the people of the book because they follow books that the original form of those books we also are meant to accept as heavenly books. However, the books that exist today, they themselves cannot guarantee the authenticity of those books. Therefore, what is left for us to say regarding those books? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and guide them as well. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide through us as well. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining what the Jews did to Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, or Moses, may peace be upon him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يَسْأَلُكَ أَهْلُ الْكِتَابِ أَن تُنَزِّلَ عَلَيْهِمْ كِتَابًا مِّنَ السَّمَاءِ. The people of the book are asking you to bring down a book from the skies, as it were, a complete booklet. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving glad tidings to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the sense that he is telling him that don't worry, tasliya, tasalli to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying, فَقَدْ سَأَلُوا مُوسَىٰ أَكْبَرَ مِنْ ذَٰلِكَ. Don't worry. They asked Musa alayhi salam something was much more difficult than that, something greater than that. فَقَالُوا أَرِنَا اللَّهَ جَهْرَةً. They said, we want to see Allah clearly in front of us. Let us see Allah, that is when we will accept. What is the point of iman and belief in the unseen if I had seen Allah, you had seen Allah, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal? There is no point of iman. Iman is to believe in the unseen. The signs have come to you, clear signs. Let us see. Do you believe or do you reject? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst the true believers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after explaining that, he explains the reality of Isa alayhi salam. He says that the Jews have claimed that they have killed Isa alayhi salam, who is Jesus, may peace be upon him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says that the Jews have really spoken ill about Mary or Maryam alayha salatu wasalam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is clarifying all this. Maryam or Mary, may peace be upon her, she was a virgin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused a soul to be placed within her, the miraculous birth of Jesus or Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ. They did not kill him, nor did they crucify him, but they were mixed up. They were mixed up. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ يَقِينًا. Indeed, they did not kill him. بَرَّفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him alive to him, meaning to Allah. And we as Muslims believe that Isa alayhi salam, or Jesus, may peace be upon him, will return to earth closer on to the day of Qiyamah. This is the belief of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, the belief of the Muslims. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning regarding the prophets to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that there are so many messengers that we sent. Some of them we have spoken to you about, some of them we haven't spoken to you about. وَرُسُلًا قَدْ قَصَصْنَاهُمْ عَلَيْكَ مِنْ قَبْلِ وَرُسُلًا لَمْ نَقْصُصْهُمْ عَلَيْكَ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the names of many anbiya alayhimus salatu was salam. 18 anbiya alayhimus salatu was salam in one verse. And then he says, there are many more, some we have spoken about and some we have not spoken about. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who knows the exact number of messengers he has sent. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues addressing the people.
يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ قَدْ جَاءَكُمُ الرَّسُولُ بِالْحَقِّ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ
O people, the messenger has come to you with the truth from his Lord or from your Lord, from your Rabb.
فَآمِنُوا خَيْرًا لَكُمْ
So believe, it is better for you. If we believe, it's better for whom? For us or for Allah? For us. This belief Allah has given us as a gift. Wallahi, we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this. How many people are walking around outside? Wallahi, look at their faces, whether it is in this country or other countries. They are dead of spirituality. There are so many illnesses they are going through because they have no belief in them. They have no spirituality in them. And if they do have a little bit of spirituality, it is the wrong sort of spirituality, that which myself and yourself would not really term spirituality. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the true understanding of the gift of this iman that we have. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, believe, it is better for you. وَإِن تَكْفُرُوا And in the case where you are not going to believe, in the case where you are going to disbelieve,
فَإِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ
So indeed, for Allah is whatever lies between the skies and the earth. You are not going to decrease His kingdom by a little fraction even. You are not going to harm Him even a little bit. This iman is your benefit. It is not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's benefit. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explaining to us His istighna. Istighna meaning He's independent. He doesn't need us. We need Him. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in surah Al-Ma'idah has mentioned the halal and haram. And in fact, he says,
وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ
A very great verse. And assist one another regarding righteousness and goodness. And do not help each other when it comes to sin and when it comes to fighting, udwan, enmity. Don't assist one another. This is a golden rule in the Sharia. Something good is there to be done, assist. Something bad people are doing, don't help. In fact, try your best to stop it. This is when you will get a reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions,
حُرِّمَتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَيْتَةِ
That verse, the entire verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us regarding the edibles. What is haram? Allah says this is haram, that is haram. The entire list is there. And thereafter Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us,
الْيَوْمَ أُحِلَّ لَكُمُ الطَّيِّبَاتِ
After mentioning what is haram, immediately he is telling us what is halal. Someone who reads it might think, oh, this list is very long. Wallahi, it is not long. Very few things are haram. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the rest of the things He has left halal for us. Most of the things through His mercy, they are halal for us. And He says, this day all good things are halal for you. This means whatever I have made halal for you is good for you. You know, there is a saying, some doctors say red meat is bad for us. Wallahi, if we look at it Islamically, it is the way you eat it that declares or that will determine whether it is bad for you or good for you. But in itself, once it is halal, bismillahi Allahu Akbar, you have slaughtered it, the blood is out, everything is done properly, wallahi, that cannot be bad for you. But if you don't know how to eat it, then it is bad for you. If you eat too much of it, it will be bad for you. So let us understand, when Allah has declared that something is halal, wallahi, it cannot be harmful for us unless we have something wrong with us or we don't know how to eat it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding of that. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to mention,
الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ
Just prior to this, he says, this day I have perfected your religion. Islam, complete. This was one of the last verses to be revealed. Some ulama have actually said it was the last, and others say that other verses were after this. But however, it was one of the last. This day I have perfected your religion. وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي And I have completed my gift to you. The gift. Remember, Islam and the rulings of the Sharia came down in stages. The Quran was revealed over a period of 23 years. So this day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I have perfected your religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, I have completed the gift that I have given you.
وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا
And I have, or I am pleased with Islam as your deen. I am happy for you. In other words, I have declared and dictated for you that Islam is your deen. What does Islam mean? Islam means submission to the command of Allah. So submission to the command of Allah is what is my deen and your deen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who submit to his command. Whenever someone comes to us with a ruling, Alhamdulillah, sami'na wa ata'na. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the strength to accept. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to mention salah. How to perform wudu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذَا قُمْتُمْ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ O you who believe when you get up for salah,
فَغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقُ وَامْسَحُوا بِرُؤُوسِكُمْ وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ إِلَى الْكَعْبَيْنِ
The wudu is being explained to us in this verse of the Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who have wudu at all times. May he accept the wudu from us. Wallahi Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will recognize his ummah by the shining of the places of wudu on the day of qiyamah. So if we are doing wudu, let us understand it is an ibadah. Let us not chat and talk to one another in the wudu khana or in the place where we make this ablution, such that we make it a market or we make it a place where we deal and we talk about our businesses. Little do we know that it is how we wash these organs of ours that will determine the nur on the day of qiyamah through which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will recognize his ummah. May he make us from amongst those who understand what is wudu. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions a very, very important aspect. In fact, all the aspects being mentioned are extremely important. He says,
وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا
Do not let the hatred you may have or the ill feeling you may have against certain people make you unjust with them. Sometimes we have a problem with someone. Sometimes there are people who follow other religions, etc. This does not mean, yes, it does mean that we have some things which are not common between us. But it does not mean we must oppress them or we must lie about them or we must go out of our way to ensure that life becomes difficult for them. No, this means that we need to be just. Through this justice that Islam has taught, we will be just to ourselves, to our children, to our enemies, and as well as those who follow other deens and other religions besides the religion of Islam. We will be just to them. How many of the kuffar have accepted Islam because of those who have been just with them, including at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? I don't have time to go into the details, but wallahi, there are many stories of this. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst those who can be just, even with those whom they don't get along with. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the details of the Jews. As I had mentioned, the various beliefs of the Jews and where they have deviated. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then says,
يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولُنَا يُبَيِّنُ لَكُمْ كَثِيرًا مِّمَّا كُنتُمْ تُخْفُونَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ
O people of the book, قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ رَسُولُنَا Our messenger has come to you. يُبَيِّنُ لَكُمْ كَثِيرًا He is making manifest and clear to you a lot of that which you have hidden. Meaning, we believe that the rabbis or the priests, etc. at that time have changed the divine books, making them unauthentic. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, look, O Jews and O Christians, don't be cheated by your rabbis and your priests. Find out. And you should understand that our messenger has come to you, making clear to you what they have, in fact, or what you as a nation have hidden. يُبَيِّنُ لَكُمْ كَثِيرًا مِّمَّا كُنْتُمْ تُخْفُونَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ That which you have hidden from the book, وَيَعْفُوا عَنْ كَثِيرٍ Immediately after that Allah says, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives many. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us as well. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the story of Habil and Qabil. Just before that, he mentions Musa alayhi salam, and he mentions the story of how Musa alayhi salam's people had made him suffer, or how they were very, very difficult with him. And after that, he mentions the story of Habil and Qabil, or Abel and Cain, the two sons of Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. When they both gave sacrifices for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one was accepted and one was not. So the one brother was taught by shaitan how to kill the other brother. And the one brother told the other, Qabil told Habil, Cain told Abel that I'm going to kill you. So Abel says, or Habil says, look, if you are going to stretch your hand to kill me, I'm not going to stretch my hand to kill you. And this teaches us a divine quality, a quality that Allah inspires, that when someone harms you, do good to them. Wallahi, I have been taught by some of the ulama and some of the mashayikh that when someone does evil against you, the best you can ever do for them is to give out a sadaqah on their behalf. Someone is working against you, someone is jealous about you, someone has done something bad against you, whatever has happened, the best you can ever do, take out a little sadaqah, whether it is ₹1, ₹2, $1, $2, $5, give it out and say, Ya Allah, this is on behalf of that person. Allah, you will see how He will make their hearts soft, your hearts also soft. You will see how He will either bring you together or He will assist you to overcome the difficulties that that person is inflicting upon you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us this quality, and may Allah inspire us to do this, and may He grant us the strength. Wallahi, a lot of strength is required to do this. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after mentioning that, He also mentions the story of the crow. The crow that came to show the brother who killed the other brother how to bury this particular brother. And this was the first time that burial was taught at the time of Adam alayhi salam. So the one crow killed the other and buried it. So this brother said, why can't I do this to my brother? This is also mentioned in the Quran. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned some stern rulings and stern punishments regarding those who spread mischief on earth. Those who go around killing innocent people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is as though they have killed entire mankind. To raise your hand and to kill an innocent person is haram in the Sharia. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forbidden this. It is haram no matter what. And if one were to do that, to kill innocent people, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that it is as though you have destroyed entire mankind. And if you have assisted someone to live, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that it is as though you have assisted entire mankind to live. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from amongst the latter and not the former. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions also about stealing and the fact that those who steal, and remember, many people think that the Sharia is so harsh. Once you steal, your hand is cut. No. There is a long procedure before that hand is cut. There is a very long procedure before that hand is cut. 8 times out of 10, most probably you will get away with it. When I say get away with it, I mean there will be a lesser punishment. But the had, the limit set by Allah, meaning the cutting of the hand, that will only happen if some severe conditions are met, meaning there are eyewitnesses who are good people, you have, or a person has stolen more than a certain amount from a certain type of a place, etc., etc. So the Sharia is not just slapdash as people think it is. It is a very complex and detailed set of laws which applies, and it is applicable at all times to all people. It is the only solution to our problems. If we have theft, let us take a look at the countries that are applying this Sharia to a certain degree. Look at Saudi Arabia, for example. Look at the theft there. It is much, much less than it is anywhere else in the world. So this in itself is showing us that the fact that Allah has placed a harsh deterrent as a punishment, it will save us as well. So we should understand that the Sharia is acceptable until Qiyamah. We must never feel that it is inferior. Inshallah, if we get a moment through these tafasir, one day I will explain to you the wisdom behind the Sharia. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to mention regarding the Torah, and Allah describes for us what is the Torah and some of the rulings that are in the Torah. وَكَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ فِيهَا أَنَّ النَّفْسَ بِالنَّفْسِ. We wrote for the Jews in that particular book, meaning in the Torah, that a soul for a soul. وَالْعَيْنَ بِالْعَيْنِ, and an eye for an eye. وَالْأَنْفَ بِالْأَنْفِ, and a nose for a nose. وَالْأُذُنَ بِالْأُذُنِ, and an ear for an ear, and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that these are the rules that we even prescribed upon the Jews. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows us in this particular book, He tells us in the Quran what He has told the Jews. Imagine, part of what is in the Torah is mentioned to us in the Quran. So a Muslim will know what was also revealed to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ هَلْ تَنْقِمُونَ مِنَّا That now, the enmity that we find from the Jews and the Christians against the Muslims, at times we find that it is very severe. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the Jews and the Christians and saying, O Jews and Christians, O people of the book, are you seeking revenge against us only because we have declared that there is no one worthy of worship besides Allah, in one Allah? هَلْ تَنْقِمُونَ مِنَّا إِلَّا أَنْ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ Is the reason for all that revenge only because we have declared that Allah is whom we believe in and we believe in what has been revealed to us and what has been revealed to you as well? I remember mentioning a few nights ago that it burns them sometimes when we say that we also believe in the original script of the Bible and the Torah. It burns them, Allah. Why? Because they want to disassociate themselves with us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them guidance and may He make them from amongst the best of people after they accept Islam. And we have seen this in the past where the Jews and the Christians who have understood, they have accepted Islam wholesale. Up to today we have seen and we are still seeing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses them at times to further this deen. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions towards the end of this particular juz, He mentions about Isa alayhi salatu wassalam. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ Those who say that Allah is Isa alayhi salam, and those who believe in this Trinity, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that they have disbelieved. They have disbelieved because there is nothing like Trinity. And they have disbelieved because the Son of Allah does not exist. There is nothing as the Son of Allah. I remember there was a man in one village when we traveled. He said, look, how can there be a son of one son of Allah? I am a human being. I have 12 children. So you are trying to tell me that God only has one child and I have 12? There is something wrong here. So even a layman can explain to us. Similarly, when it comes to Thalith or Thalatha, when it comes to this Trinity, at times we find, or in fact I have heard laymen, people saying that, look, if we have three, there was one chief of a village. He says, listen, I am the chief. If there were three chiefs, then there would be disaster. The village, who would decide and what would happen? So he says, this is why I know there is one Allah, because I know I am one chief and I am the decider in this community and Allah is the decider in the universe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide such people and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us as well. So at the end, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us and He tells us that those who do not discourage that which is bad. Listen to what happened to them. They were cursed by Allah. لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ Allah is mentioning those people from Banu Israel who were cursed. Allah says, كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَنْ مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ They never discouraged when someone did bad. When someone did bad, they didn't bat an eyelid. So Allah says that was bad. What they did was evil. They were cursed because of that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not curse us because of that. And may He make us from amongst those who enjoin that which is good and discourage that which is bad. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.